And hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm Francisco, and today we're talking about a super common and incredibly frustrating problem, how to factory reset your Samsung phone without a password. And so maybe you're locked out because you forgot your PIN, password, or pattern, or perhaps your screens are completely unresponsive. Or maybe you're getting ready to sell your device and need to securely wipe your personal data, but you can't even get past the lock screen. You're probably thinking, how do I even begin to factory reset my Samsung phone without a password? Well, good news for you. I got you covered. In this video, I'll show you three simple, effective methods to get your Samsung device working again. These methods work for all kinds of Samsung Galaxy phones, Samsung tablets, and even older models. Best of all, you won't need your forgotten password or even a Google account password for the main hard reset method. Let's go ahead and dive right in. So moving on to part one, important before you start. Now, before we jump into the actual steps, it's super important to understand one thing. A factory reset will erase everything on your device. I'm talking about all of your photos, videos, apps, contacts, all of them will be gone. So if you somehow can't access your phone, or you have recent backups on Google Drive or Samsung Cloud, please make sure that you back up your data first. However, if losing data is a deal breaker, here's some really good news. Dr.Fone Screen Unlock features a powerful third-party tool that, for certain Samsung and even LG phones, can actually unlock your device without losing your data. It's not guaranteed for every single model, especially the very latest ones, so definitely check the website for compatibility. But if data preservation is your top priority, this could be your lifesaver. Also, make sure that your phone has at least 50% battery, or even better, just keep it plugged in. You don't want it dying in the middle of the reset. And a quick tip, if you have a physical SIM card or an SD card in your phone, take them out to keep any data on them safe. So let's begin with method one, remote reset using Google Find My Device. First up, let's look at how to perform a factory reset Android phone remotely using Google's Find My Device service. This method is fantastic if your phone is lost, stolen, or you simply can't physically access it. Now here's how that works. On a computer or another phone, go to google.com/android/find. You'll need to log in using the same Google account that was linked to your locked Samsung phone. Once it locates your device, you'll see options on the left side. Click on Erase Device. Now confirm your choice, and Google will remotely wipe your phone, performing a full factory reset of your Samsung Galaxy. This works even if you've forgotten your password. Just a heads up, your phone must be turned on, connected to Wi-Fi or mobile data, and signed into that Google account beforehand. But if it meets those requirements, this method is a total lifesaver. As such, we can begin with method number two. Remote reset using Samsung Find My Mobile. Similar to Google's service, Samsung also offers its own remote tool called Samsung Find My Mobile. This is another excellent option if you have a Samsung account linked to your phone and the remote unlock feature was enabled in your phone settings before it got locked. Here's exactly how it works. On your computer or another device, open your browser and go to findmymobile.samsung.com. Log in using the same Samsung account that's on your locked phone. Now, once it finds your device, click on Erase Data. Samsung will then remotely wipe your phone and reset it, all without you needing the lock screen password at all. Again, remember, your phone needs to be turned on, connected to Wi-Fi or mobile data, and signed into that Samsung account. But if it is, this method is incredibly handy for performing a factory reset, Samsung tablet or even phone, like a reset of, let's say, Galaxy Tab A without a password. And let's get into method number three. The one-click reset using Dr.Fone. There are going to be two options for this one. Now, if the manual methods seem a bit too technical, or you're looking for a simpler, more automated solution, a third-party tool like Dr.Fone can be a fantastic option. Dr.Fone offers a user-friendly way to unlock your phone, and it's perfect if you forgot your PIN, got a second-hand phone, or even if your screen is broken. What's really cool is that Dr.Fone gives you two main options. Option number one is the standard unlock mode, which does wipe all data. This works for most Android devices, and we'll factory reset your Android phone, meaning it will clear all of that data on your phone. This is similar to the hard reset, but it's done through the software interface, which can be easier if physical buttons are tricky or unresponsive. So just go ahead and follow these steps. Download Dr.Fone on your computer, and you will find that link in the description below. Open it and choose Screen Unlock, then pick Android and select Samsung. Choose Standard Mode. This works for most models. Connect your phone with a USB cable. Follow the on-screen instructions. Dr.Fone will guide you to put your phone into a specific mode, like download mode or recovery mode. Then Dr.Fone will remove the lock screen and initiate a full reset. It will erase all of your data, just like a traditional factory reset on Samsung, but it's super simple and works even if your buttons don't. As for option number 2, you can unlock without data loss, but this will only work for specific Samsung devices. This is the game changer. If you have a supported Samsung device like certain Galaxy S6, Note 4, etc., you'll need to check Dr.Fone's website for specific compatibility. Now, Dr.Fone can actually unlock your phone without wiping any of your data. This is incredibly useful if you haven't backed up your photos or messages and then you ran into some issues. Now, the steps are quite similar. Open Dr.Fone, go to Screen Unlock, but this time specifically pick the Unlock Android Screen Without Data Loss option. Pick your exact model from the list, connect your phone, and let the tool do the work. Just like that, your phone is unlocked, and all of your stuff is still working there. Remember, always verify compatibility for your specific Samsung model on the Dr.Fone website, especially if you're aiming for that amazing data preserving unlock. It's a powerful tool, but knowing its limitations is key. Now moving on to part 2, what happens after the factory reset? So you've successfully performed the factory reset on your Samsung. What happens next? Your phone will eventually reboot to the welcome screen, just like it did when you first took it out of the box. You'll go through the initial setup process, choosing your language, connecting to Wi-Fi, and so on. Now, a very important point is that due to something called Factory Reset Protection, or FRP, you might be asked to enter the details of the previously synced Google account that was on the phone before the reset. This is a security measure to prevent unauthorized access. If you don't know those details, you won't be able to proceed. Whether you've forgotten your login details or bought a secondhand device that's locked, Dr.Fone provides you a way to bypass FRP lock. So subscribe to this channel and you'll find the answer. And there you have it. You've just found out about exactly how to factory reset your Samsung mobile phone without a password, covering the most effective methods to get your device back in action. Whether you need to reset your Galaxy Tab without a password or just perform a general factory reset on the Samsung Galaxy, you're now a pro. If this video helps you out, please give it a big thumbs up, subscribe for more helpful tech tutorials, and leave a comment below if you have any questions or other tips that worked for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.